Hello, Lucy fans. Welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is KJ Ricardo. Today's episode is going to be looking at the top 10 Ricky and Fred moments on I Love Lucy. Now, a while back, I did a similar episode looking at the top 10 Lucy and Ethel moments. That's exactly what I'm going to do for this episode. I'm going to be looking at these two great friends and seeing the awesome moments on the show between them two. So let's get started. Number 10 is the black wig. This episode begins with Lucy wanting to own an Italian, she wants an Italian haircut. She finds a wig, puts it on, and thinks that she can fool Ricky into not recognizing her. She is immediately stunned when he starts flirting with her because he knows that it's Lucy. But she doesn't know that, and so she wants to get back at him by going to dinner with him, having Ethel and Fred along. But Ricky and Fred have a different idea. They team up. This is one of the great episodes where they scheme together, and they are going to have the waiter at the restaurant tell Lucy and Ethel that Ricky and Fred met some other women and went home with them. And of course, Lucy and Ethel are upset at that. But at the very end, Ricky and Fred come out and everyone is reunited and happy. But I chose this one because it's just a great episode between Ricky and Fred. Number 9 is Ricky Minds the Baby. I love this episode. This episode is great because Ricky has the day off. He's going to take care of little Ricky. Lucy has the day off of being a mother. And we get the classic awesome scene where Ricky tells a bedtime story. But during the day, Fred helps out and they're going to take care of little Ricky together until they turn the TV on and start watching the fights. The door is left open and of course, little Ricky's like, okay, I'm going to go through this door. He goes through the door and walks down the hall to the Mertz's door. Lucy finds him. Is so upset and wants to teach Ricky a lesson by calling him and say, can I check up on little Ricky? They see that he's gone. They immediately start freaking out, looking all over the apartment. Where is little Ricky? Fred eventually finds little Ricky, takes him back to the Ricardos, puts him in his crib without telling anyone. And the final scene, everyone comes together and finds little Ricky mysteriously back in the crib. Number 8 is Lucy Gets a Paris Gown. This is great because at the very beginning, Ricky and Fred don't want the girls to go to a fashion show because they know they'll want to buy a dress. Their reactions to the dresses are hysterical. And they're pretty accurate. Some of these dresses are very wild. They don't get it why they want this dress, especially Lucy. She goes on this fake hunger strike to get a dress. When Ricky finds out, he wants to get back at her. Ricky and Fred team up once again to scheme against Lucy and Ethel and make these fake dresses, these hideous dresses. And so they work together and convince them into thinking that these are real dresses until they tell them the truth and they get mad, of course, but it's just a great episode between Ricky and Fred. Number 7 is Drafted. People have some mixed feelings about this episode, but it is from the first season. Ricky is going to perform a war show for the military, and he brings Fred along. Fred did serve in the war, but Lucy and Ethel think that Ricky and Fred were drafted. They were drafted and they're sewing all the time. They're crying all the time. So Ricky and Fred think that Lucy and Ethel were actually pregnant. They're pregnant even though they're not. And it's a great episode because Ricky and Fred are practicing their show together, but also just the concept of being drafted. Number 6 is The Gossip. I really like this episode. It's one of my favorites from season 1. Lucy is gossiping all the time, and Ethel gossips too. But Lucy and Ethel say that the boys gossip as well. So there's a bet between who can go the longest without gossiping. Ricky and Fred come up with this scheme to trick Lucy and Ethel into gossiping first. They tell this story in their sleep about Grace Foster running away with a milkman. Of course, Lucy thinks it's real, even though it's not, and wants to tell Ethel. They're caught gossiping and have to give Ricky and Fred breakfast in bed for a month. When they are having their breakfast in bed, which is very cute, the milkman comes in, and then Mr. Foster comes in with a gun. And so it seems like the story is actually true, so that the men were gossiping. But it was just Lucy getting back at Ricky and Fred. It's a great episode. Number 5 is deep sea fishing. This is from season 6. They're in Florida. And there's a bet between the men and the women, once again, of who can catch the largest fish. Lucy and Ethel buy a really big tuna fish, but so does Ricky and Fred. This episode is great because Ricky and Fred are really working together, bringing the fish back and forth, back and forth. They're teaming up together. It's a great episode because they're always together. Pretty much the entire episode is them two versus the women. Eventually, they do go fishing, and the women do win the bet, but it's just a great episode. Number 4 is the golf game. I love this episode because, of course, the men love golfing and golf all the time, and so Lucy and Ethel want to join them on their next golfing trip. Ricky and Fred don't want them to golf all the time, so they come up with these ridiculous rules to the game of golf. Not true at all, but Ricky and Fred are teaming up, and they are in this 100% to fool Lucy and Ethel into thinking that this is how you play golf, until they meet real life pro Jimmy Demerit, and he helps Lucy and Ethel get back at Ricky and Fred. It's a great episode featuring Ricky and Fred's passion of golf. Number 3 is changing the boys' wardrobe. This is a great episode because in the beginning, Ricky doesn't want to change his clothes to go to the movies. He wants to wear his casual attire. But Lucy makes him change. Fred comes in with the same kind of clothes, these casual clothes, doesn't know what's wrong with them. When Ricky sees that Fred is wearing these clothes, he says, "Just a minute." And he says, "Nope, I'm going to change back into my clothes." They come back together laughing because some woman gave Fred a dime. And it's great. Lucy and Ethel decide to sell all of the boys' old clothes. But the store owner tells Ricky about this and sells him the clothes back. And so Ricky gets his plaid shirt back. But at the club, Ricky is voted one of the best dressed men in America, and Fred is his fashion consultant, which is great. And then Lucy and Ethel come down in really bad clothes. It's so funny. It's just a great episode. Number 2 is Ricky and Fred are TV fans. This is a great Ricky and Fred episode. They're watching the fights. They're ignoring their wives. They are so into the fights. As I've said before, the fights were everything in the 1950s. They're betting against each other on who will win. They are so engrossed in this that they don't even know that their wives are getting in trouble. Lucy and Ethel get arrested, and they are in jail, basically. And they don't even know it the whole time, and that is so hilarious. It's just such a great Ricky and Fred episode. All right, now I have some honorable mentions before I get to my number 1 pick. So let's see what these are. Vacation for Marriage is another great episode with Ricky and Fred teaming up together, as well as Lucy Goes to Monte Carlo. Ricky and Fred get into a fight over money. It's great. The Fur Coat, Ricky and Fred scheme up together once again. Equal Rights is great, where Ricky and Fred team up together to get back at the girls. And then In Palm Springs, where the boys are back in Hollywood enjoying life. My number one pick, of course, is Job Switching. Now, Job Switching is usually associated with Lucy and Ethel, with the Candy Factory. This is called, like, the Candy Factory episode. But a lot of people forget the whole other side of this episode is Ricky and Fred back at home trying to be housewives. They are trying to cook, and we get this disaster with the chicken and the rice. The rice is overflowing on the stove. It is hilarious. This episode is hilarious with Lucy and Ethel, but it is just as hilarious with Ricky and Fred. They don't know what they're doing. And I think that's one of the classic elements of this episode, is that the women don't know what they're doing, but also the men don't know what they're doing at home. And it's just such a great episode, and I love it. So that's my list of the top 10 Ricky and Fred moments. What's your list? Let me know. I love Fred and Ricky. They are just as best friends as Lucy and Ethel are, and they will go through life together. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next week. Tell me your list in a comment below, and I'll be reading. Thanks, and remember to always inspire change.